back to Chinese operation. Unleash in Grand Cross is a 26 to China. This is the outcome of my background back in Nigeria. What the opposite potentially presented of relief against drugs, sea value transfer, is a question of the my side is really to make it interactive, stop anywhere, talk about it. But I guess the whole idea was actually to share information or share experience, because that's what this is all about. It's a journey nobody has achieved before. I'm hoping I'll get some insight from you as well. I did from a very wonderful presentation, a very good job. What's the brand? Over the last 2 years, this 5-letter word has turned up some multifaceted and very interesting definition. I can tell you there's so many definitions about the brand. And you know, for me, because I hear so much of it, and you know, the more esoteric it sounds, people feel that it really gives them the impression that you know so much about it, you know it's an esoteric thing, but it's really very simple. More marketing practitioners agree that the brand is more than a logo, or that it's a symbol, a color, or a representation that helps distinguish position. Brands and I increasingly define that emotional concept that creates positive emotions. The gentleman actually tried to take this to that to his presentation. Logos, colors, logos, statements, and decisions and promotion all seem to serve the purpose of communicating and reinforcing the brand. One mantra I keep preaching to people, especially brand practitioners and those in the market of communication, is that you will not and you can never build a brand it's not the number of ads or the number of TV commercials that you have that will build the brand. It's really your customers. It's really the experience they get consistently over time. If they don't feel it that way, if they don't get it, no matter how many times you show them that advert, it won't work. It doesn't last. Honestly, the true time-tested brands are those who have been true to what this is about. The growth of the internet, and I don't mean the internet, but not the last 15 years, is going to impact the customer interaction and certainly be a traditional marketplace. Those of us who are bankers around here, we know that this is real. IT and advancements made by intellectuals has created new opportunities for the financial services industry. In ways that have affected product development, the media and marketing network. Honestly, it has changed our lives completely. It started in terms of product innovation, service delivery, and is now truly creeping into the way financial institutions and brands are positioning themselves. I'll try not to only talk about financial institutions, I'll try and make it a bit more expansive over the other conversation. But truly, it has changed our way of life. So I said, the internet and IT have both greatly impacted consumer habits and continue to dramatically transform consumer behavior. The major consequences for how the new breed of consumer develops familiarity with and ultimate loyalty to the financial brands. More people are very careful with money and people are very sensitive. And for those in banks, you must be honest with yourself. Now, 2010 and the past 6 months, I've been a trying time for that industry. The consumer is very careful. The consumer is very, you know, it's a bit sensitive to a lot of things. Because everybody is afraid of losing their money. Nobody wants any, you know, so there are responses to things that are happening now. Sometimes have fierce and violent. And unlike in the a few years ago where you couldn't feel the impact unless you went to TV and the website didn't have that kind of access or they went to the newspaper. Today, if you upset a customer, if you see millions, it's online. It's all in 10 minutes online. They haven't gone as far and as sophisticated as the United Online. But I tell you, they are screaming and shouting. They are screaming and shouting online. So honestly,
I mean, some of the things he said are real. And for organizations that are taking their brands very seriously, have to look at that part. Your consumers now have a voice. Your customers now have a voice and a platform to deal with it. Honestly, that account officer or that teller in some branch in Bukari or in Gombe, who is not, you know, attending to a customer properly. Honestly, that customer can deal with that teller. They just go online. And it's more disastrous for that organization. Because everybody, you know, if there's that bad brand on your face, that's true, yes. When I went to that branch, they did this to me. Yes, and then the whole thing just comes. Because everybody wants to associate with the underdog and get this man, let's support him, or let's support her cause. But it's real. On one thing, looking at globalization, the phenomena that has greatly increased international competition between banks, financial and non-financial organizations. Truly, these days, we're not positioned. Most organizations are taking themselves seriously. And I'll say, if you can teach us, for instance, we don't position ourselves as a Nigerian company or a Nigerian bank. We're African, including. Look at what is happening. Standard Bank is in Nigeria. There are other international banks coming into our market, so we can't say we're just looking for players. We have to position ourselves to compete globally. So whatever best practices there, whatever trends there, we want to ensure that we're ahead of the pack. E-marketing and e-brand building is never going to be the same. The web has become a powerful communication to where consumers go to connect, research, and entertain themselves. I remember you tried to take control of what people are learning from that. Businesses, as a matter of fact, need to maintain a solid presence where the conversation and the experience are taking place. You cannot ignore those online conversations. Do you know it's suicidal for a company, especially a bank? I'm using my words carefully. It's not important, it's suicidal if you know it. It's like you spend so much time and money building your physical branches and training your staff and trying to deal with your customers in those very typical traditional brick and mortar outlets. And then you leave your website, you leave all that to maybe disgruntled customers to shift, because it's all about perception. Do you know that? I'm sure you all are. It's all about perception. And that's where the branding is very interesting, because you need to shape that perception right. You can't leave it to people. Because all you need is a pack of disgruntled consumers and customers to keep talking on some sites for the next 6 hours. You will feel the impact. And sometimes reactionary solutions, they are almost, the whiplash effect is even worse. So honestly speaking, the best thing is to be there while they are discussing. Follow those threads. Follow those conversations. Most times they are not really, it really can't satisfy you. Nobody really can. I think there's this local parlance of that. You can't play. Satisfy, please, if you can't satisfy me, because now what happened to ATM is you know, you start griping about internet access tomorrow, or like the receptionist didn't smile at them, or they went to not sleep in banking on, or the AC, the temperature wasn't right. There's always something to grip about, depends on which side of the bed they go for. Not all successful brands are able to transfer their successes online. It is so true. Let's be honest. Let's be real. A lot of the successful organizations like Google Ads, social media is very new. It's only the new generation that people understand. Let's be real. Now, because it's almost intangible, we talk about return on investment and all that, it's so difficult to track it. Now, why am I so passionate about it? It's because I'm in an area, my business is dealing with intangibles. You create something for nothing. but the impact is felt real. Now, how do you know, no matter what people say, there is still, and I'm ready to challenge anybody, there is still no scientific, accurate correlation that can draw a line between what you spend on marketing and your P&L. How much I spend on sponsorships and on branding. There is no scientific correlation. You can't draw that line. We can just have, we'll talk to the ACMLC and they give us reports and research, and we'll try and give you a hazy how it has impacted. But there's still nothing. Nothing. Now, social media, that social platform is the same thing in the world. So you find out that the executives are not, one is new to you. As I said, it's not culture. It's not about building a branch. I build a branch because $50 million to build that branch. I know where we're going to bring people. It's not about that branch. It's easy. Now, deploying funds to this new platform is usually more difficult because it's still not clearly defined. This platform is really seen for those who just want to interact. Call social media, maybe that's why we should even change that to really make it easier for us to market. It's seen as social. In the workplace, the first thing they yank off is Facebook. Take it off. They spend their time chatting. But you see, it's because it's new to them and they can't see the power in this platform. A few who have seen the power are pushing. We have seen the because, sorry, I keep going here and there. As I said, I want to keep it interactive. I keep it here. You know, the success you get, you know, you set up a company and you make money from those branches, for instance. Some organizations tend to get arrogant. It's like customer service. It's not the number one. People pay a lot of new services, you know, for customer service. But how many organizations are true to it? I give an example, the chief customer service officer in Nigeria, and it's not. If you write a text, if you want to get a response, write a letter to send my name. You will read it. It's like, yeah, I'm a government. It's not this thing. You will read your email because it's important to you. It's important to you hear what people are saying about your education and which you want. So it's also all about managing the way the organization wants to interact with its customers. You still take that, you know, you say, take the success in your physical branches or physical whatever you have now, and take it on now. You see that transition is difficult. Because sometimes you say you want to profile the customer, you want to know. It's difficult sometimes. But we'll go through it and I'll tell you how we'll be able to do that. People respond to them to online branding and they look. With the other traditional market channels that they use. It's really real. Let's look at what we need to do for people who are on social media. The other ones are living here. We're all keeping it here. You know? You hear kids now say, can you imagine? I heard some people say, my dad is on Facebook. This is crazy. But it's true. You hear the young kids say, so for a colleague of mine, kids abroad. I think my kids on Facebook, I'm always trying to look for feedback and just to understand what people are thinking about it, especially the young ones. They have the future, you know, so we really need to be successful. And I said, oh, your kids, they're on Facebook, have they invited you? And I said, but do you know what they're talking about? You think nice. He said, that's true. And right there and there, he called his son. I didn't even speak to him. And he said, oh, that's enough. I'm now on Facebook, please invite me. And the song goes,
time was quite short. Because a long story short, obviously you never invited
his father. Let me just share something similar. I even went one step further, and my son was logged on to Facebook. So I managed to get creep, you know, we went to the kitchen. I went and I invited myself.
Not you. You know, you need to understand. You said people respond differently to online gambling. For instance, it's more informal. Online communication is obviously more informal. It's quick, it's easy. But real issues are discussed there. That's really where you go. Now, with the traditional advertising, it's one way. No. It's one way. You really can't engage. You put up an advert there. It's only if I get to doing things like adverts, this year, doing commercials, what do you see? That's what happens. So you really don't know. You don't really get the feedback to how people perceive or feel about your position. See, this is who men do to be very quickly. You put a post up there, and I'm sure as you're trying to upload, there's some fantasy for it. Keep happy the way. You know? And they're responding. So, it's like people respond differently to online branding and online traditional. Sometimes they feel freer, you know, online, because I guess you don't know where they are. Faceless, you know, they're no users. In the banking hall, they don't want to do it themselves, they don't want to start shouting, they don't want to think they ordinarily won't have said. Yes, they can get a safe. So it's different. So we realize that even the kind of communication we put out there, that can't be seen, we are getting that. Remember those days? The mask can carry me. Banking has come a long way from the time of legends and starting numbers and cumbersome manner of privacy that we never understand. The computer now, more than ever, has become an established tool for achieving a competitive edge and optimal resource allocation. You mentioned a lot of that. So it's become a critical component of customer, excellent customer service, which is true. Because what it does is that, I mean, we all realize that as much as possible, we can automate and move people to electronic channels. It's actually standardizing the kind of service we use. So it's not a question of, this is my own life, I really have to do it. This digitalization has enabled financial institutions responding to the request for customers to statement of accounts, balance inquiries, signature and email verification systems, the time taken to offer typical cashier services, with the advent of the ATMs and the IT of the banking digital funds, are now able to serve customers after the banking. You won't bring to talk about convenience for me. But you realize that customers are resisting this mortality challenge. They still want to come into our office. They still want to meet the teller. They still want to ask you, so what is my balance? You know, that's what I'm saying, that it sounds nice. You know, the textbook says it nicely. But guess what? Human beings are difficult and they're different from each other in life. They still want to come into your banking halls.
That's a very good point, actually, because there was an advert on NatWest Banking and advert basically, and they were actually taking, you would expect they would take electronic channels to the rural areas in UK. What they were doing actually was taking just a bus to the the rural areas in the UK to, for people to still actually meet people. So the whole essence was they still like their Saturday morning chit chat with the customers. They still want to come in and sit down, have a chat with them, as against, you know, putting electronic channels out there for the customers to use, which would be more convenient. So in our service, we're trying to say each channel, there's still that aspect of relationship, you know, from customers to the banking halls.
I think the key variable is actually the target market to look at. Because looking at people aged 25, age 30, between 18 and 30, who are your customers of tomorrow, they most likely will be the normal second time talking to everybody. The guy has one hand on the BlackBerry and will most likely just punch in his brain and walk away from the man. Doesn't need to interact. The challenge you face are your existing old customers who are not as kind of us as you like them to be.
It's hard to deal with because, you know, today's market, like I said, I'm trying not to tie it only to the financial business. You know, it's all that people are conscious about. You know, you hear the 13-year-olds saying, I can't get over it. These are people, don't even know them. So, you know, they say it's very crowded. That way it eliminates any fraud. So I don't. You don't need to buy 5,000 naira. You will trace it all the way to the bank. Wait. You know, for the point is like it's all about you. Like, I swear to you, so that I'm still finding the blessing of customers. We have to cater to a lot of, you know, different people now. People will all get there. Nigeria?
The other one I also want to look at is the issue of some people who need to be told. Some people really are not so free talking about users. Think for instance, when you travel and you see a sum of workers not only get checking machines. People don't like checking. Some people are afraid of you, or somehow have that resistance to try those technological solutions.
You know, you want to buy train tickets. Instead of, you know, if you have those trains, you will still cure. Meanwhile, you can just go out. Some people, and even those of us who don't pay for a big techie, I mean, Nigeria has the fastest growing in the market. It's over 9,930. And it's still growing. It's growing. Abbas has not realized the potential of our new services to deliver our services from the customers. We realize that the advanced technology will present opportunities to engage our customers. We talk about our brand families, while growing customer base. Right from the beginning, we realize that technology reports will be used to make this platform actually can achieve the services to our customers. Marketers who intend to still do business in this way need to stress this strategy from the right of issues and align brand investments with new data about how customers interact with brand companies. People from our interactions here this morning tell me we cannot get feedback. And we realize that truly is not a one size fits all. It's definitely not. Let's even look at our customers in Nigeria. Those are for broken out businesses just dealing in Nigeria. Geographically, religiously, you have to look at all kinds of strange factors. We have to put all those things together to even ensure that when one is crafting a strategy for our brand online, we need to put those factors out to bring them to play and come out with a blueprint. Only by strategically composing the marketing can marketers drive traffic, build brand equity, and capture customer loyalty. In the past few years, banking activities have increasingly relying on the government in this area. We have gone from the days when we used to camp out of banks as a mass problem, and business is just on, you know, on our computers, or laptops, or somewhere else. sometimes bring the phone to people. Today, more than ever, people are using the internet to pay their bills or collect their financial information. Friends, real time, online, have not become part of the daily life, and it doesn't look like a good progress. All of this is giving improved transactions and importance to us. What we did, innovation, service, and technology. During the course of the last decade, we realized that technology will be an important part of our role in our sales quality and interaction with our customers. Then we took a rigorous research to identify key and relevant areas where expertise, confidence, and skill sets were required. Research, some of the fallout of the things we covered and covered the language. Our internet banking, our interactive contact center, Europe and electrical gen, email and SMS transaction GT Mobile, GT Bank, e-branch, and we have a successful location nationwide. Our ATM, GT Bank has been able to do the moving back from the ATMs, the vault, the moving from location to location. From the corporate website and other microsites, and our new media profile. So, this is the trial of the government. From 1992, Bank introduced Nigeria to online banking. Interesting, I think, just like 20 years this year.